We stumbled upon this story yesterday and got a big kick out of it. The former Missouri quarterback, Chase Daniel, put on a bucket hat, sunglasses, and went out looking for autographs from his Chicago Bears teammates, wearing a jersey. The Mitchell, he's wearing a number 10 jersey, fooled a lot of people there. And even Mitchell Trubisky, I think, got fooled initially. And Chase Daniel joins us now. I know you got a lot of time on your hands here, but that much time to come up with this caper? How long were you working on this?
I know. It was pretty funny. Actually, the social media staff here at the Bears just had the idea, and they were floating around for a couple weeks. And at first, I didn't really want to do it, but it sort of grew on me, and just I saw where it could go, and it probably turned out a little better than we thought.
It wasn't a great disguise, though, Chase. You didn't put a whole lot of time into that disguise, did you?
No, not at all. I just, I saw a bucket hat laying around. I said, what's better to wear at camp on a sunny day than a nice little bucket hat? Got some Nike shades on, put the Mitch jersey on, and just rolled.
I worry about Trubisky's ability to, being able to pick up things, you know, on the field here. If he can't pick up you asking for an autograph here, Chase, might be in trouble.
Hey, we gave him so much stuff for that because he was, like, so focused in just signing stuff. And all of a sudden, he just sees this big kid. And, you know, he told me, he's like, I saw you with the beer, but, like, I didn't put two and two together because I was so focused in on just signing autographs. And obviously, you saw his reaction was pretty priceless. I think that was one of the best things of the video.
What is your role as backup at practice?
Yeah, that's a good question. You know, my role and the reason why the Bears brought me in was to not only get Mitch ready to play during the game, but also to get myself ready. So it's sort of twofold, right? So you're supposed to do everything in your power to get the backup ready, or to get the starter ready, excuse me. But also, you're sort of wearing two hats. If something were to happen, you have to be ready to play as well.
But there's the competitor in you. Like you almost have to resign yourself to the fact that you're not going to start. And if you do start, something bad has probably happened, but you're still in an important role here. Like it's got to be a weird range of emotions for you.
There's no question. And you know, I've been doing it for 10 years now, so you sort of get the hang of it. But you definitely have to keep your edge, right? Like it's something where you don't want to just not be prepared, right? So I have to prepare week in, week out, just like I'm going to be the starter right by each other, right? And like you said, it's probably something bad that happened if I'm starting, but I'm definitely ready for it, that's for sure.
He's Chase Daniel, the Bears' backup quarterback and amateur imposter as well, joining us, Dan Patrick Show. I want you to tell me if this is true or not, and you're not in the Saints camp anymore, so you can be honest. Were you allowed to show up earlier than Drew Brees? Or did Brees have to show up before everybody else?
Yeah, you know, I would definitely beat him in sometimes, but I definitely got some words from him. You know, he's like a big brother to me. We've got a really good relationship. But, I'd try to show up at 5:30. He'd be there at 5:25. I'd be there at 5:20 the next day. He'd be there at 5:15. So it was sort of like some bravado, right? Like you had to be the first one in the building. And I respect that. And that's sort of where I've taken – you know, with me from place to place.
Have you ever been on Hard Knocks?
I haven't. I didn't watch the episode either last night. I heard there was some pretty good material. I think it'd be pretty funny because, to be a fly on our wall in our quarterback meeting room right now with Mitch and Tyler Bray and Coach Ragone and Coach Helfrich and even Matt Nagy as well, it would be pretty funny.
What would you tell Baker Mayfield about being a backup, at least a temporary backup?
Yeah, that's a good question, right? It's a whole different situation. I was undrafted. He was the first pick overall, right? And, you know, they're telling him he's the backup. But it's a little bit of – it hurts your ego a little bit, right? Like if you're, you know, a Heisman Trophy winner, you're playing in all these big-time games in college. But I would just say, Tyrod, I know him personally, and he's an amazing pro, right? So learn as much as you possibly can from him. Get in his head. Go with him. I saw the little – you know, between him and Hugh, where he was like, where are your little workouts in the morning? I thought that was pretty cool. And that's true, right? You want to base yourself off the starter and put as much time as possible into it.
Have you ever totaled up your preseason stats?
I haven't. I have not.
Okay. Those are your numbers, and I know you take great pride when you get a chance to play, but I was curious if – I know you got one touchdown pass in your career, right?
Yes. Yep, that was my first start in San Diego, 2014, I believe. We were resting the starters. It was the Dexter McCluster. I remember it.
You got the ball?
I do. It's actually in my man cave downstairs, so it's pretty cool. And Dexter and I are still pretty close, so it's funny to hear him talk about it. But yeah, it was a cool experience.
Do you remember the play?
It was actually a RPO before everyone was doing it. We were ahead of the curve. I'll tell you what.
Wait, you were ahead of everybody on the RPO.
We were ahead of the curve, man. Nice. We had it in 2014. It was a run-pass option, and they didn't cover down on him. They threw a little bubble to him, and he did the rest.
If you're late for the meeting this morning, what happens?
I'm actually standing outside the quarterback room right now, and they're all looking at me like I'm crazy. But I think I got a little leeway being 10-year pro, so we're all good.
All right. Hey, Chase, that was fun. And hopefully you get a chance to get some run here, and we appreciate your time.
Hey, Dan, thanks for having me on, man. I really appreciate it.
That's Chase Daniel, Bears backup quarterback.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV or download the Dan Patrick Show app.